Before I start photographing this apartment, that is one of the apartments that we ran on Airbnb, I wanted to do a quick video that I plan to be like every week episode. It's gonna be like top 6 things, and every Wednesday I'll be talking about top 6 things that are related to photography, and I think that it can be interesting. So for today I wanted to talk about the top 6 most profitable, most lucrative photography styles if you plan to do a photography business. So before you start a business, you might want to know how much you can earn from these photography styles. And especially now, in this past decade, photography has become so popular that every kid and its pet literally just are slapping the word photography after their last name on the pictures and trying to sell photography services. To become a professional photographer is not just enough to be an amazing artist. You really need to know your way around business, to have the sense for it. So when you combine your amazing art together with the sense of business, then you're officially a professional photographer. Let's say you manage to remove this obstacle called amateur photographer square, trying to sell photography services for cheap money. Now you need to face the pros. So in every photography field, like in every other field of business, there are professionals who are already doing the thing. But photography is a big, big ocean. So if you have the qualities, you can always find a gig. So in the end, it's not your goal to knock out every other photographer out there. It's just, you can find your own gigs, you can find your own clients, and then maybe in the end, with the competition, you can do a merger and you can sell your services together. There is a job for everybody if you have the qualities. So before you start your photography business, stay tuned for these top 6 most profitable photography styles. Let's start from number 6. My most favorite and the least profitable business in the whole photography world is documentary, photojournalism, and street photography. I mean, it's so freaking difficult to sell this kind of photography. Doesn't matter if you try to sell it in a gallery. Let me make it this much more nicer, like to be nicely framed. Yeah, I think this is pretty. Yeah, that's good. Okay, so as I said, this is the least profitable photography style in the world. So if you want to start your photography business, maybe street photography or documentary is not the real deal for you. But photojournalism, it really depends on you. Depends how much you're gonna risk your life. So if you decide now to go to Syria, where the bombs are flying every day, every hour, yeah, you might get some good shots, but not necessarily come back alive. But if you just work as a ordinary photojournalist in a magazine and you always hunt for a story or for a moment, yeah, that doesn't really happen very often. I mean, once in a lifetime moment doesn't happen every day. It might never happen. If it does happen, then yeah, you can sell it for lots of money. For me, for example, I was in Nepal in 2015 and I went back home April the 20th, something like that. 5 days afterwards, the major earthquake happened. I mean, yeah, of course, my family was super happy and everybody would be happy that I wasn't there in the moment. But from photographer's point of view, it was really a miss on a photo story. So I know a guy that was there just randomly. They were on a vacation with his girlfriend just to go do some hiking. But yeah, of course, he's a photojournalist and he has the camera always with him. He was there in the right time, in the right moment, on the right spot. And guess what? He sold a photograph for $40,000. I won't say the name, I won't say the magazine where he sold his picture, but just to say that, yeah, money can be made if the moment is right. Even if the moment is right, you need to capture that emotion, you need to capture the story. As they say, one picture tells millions of stories. Okay, so number 6 on my top 6 most profitable photography style is documentary / photojournalism / street photography. Just to mention something, that if you're interested in photojournalism and freelancing in photojournalism, you might want to watch the Bang Bang Club. It's a movie about photographers who are in South Africa in the times where the civil war was raging there. So check the movie if you haven't watched it before. I will leave the link below. So yeah, number 5 is stock photography. I hate stock photography. I literally hate it. It's so boring. I cannot really express myself. I don't get the artistic feeling when I'm doing stock photography. But doesn't matter what I feel, it does bring some money. I've read that there are people that are earning from 30 to 60k a year just by doing stock photography. I mean, these people have over thousands actually photos on their portfolio on Shutterstock or iStock or any other stock photography website. I mean, again, it depends all on you. How much you know your camera and how much you're willing to work. And believe me, for stock photography, you really need to work day and night. Not just that you work day and night, you will never imagine the things that you will be photographing. I found myself that I was photographing the tip of a fork. I was photographing the key, rusty part of a key. And then, I mean, so crazy thing, dust on a TV, everything is selling. I mean, people are buying crazy things online, so yeah, you should also take pictures of crazy things and then sell them. I didn't manage to fill up my portfolio as much as I wanted to because I started making money from my documentary photography, but I think that I was about to continue with stock photography, that I would have filled up the portfolio and then totally stop with this style of photography. I maybe even stop with photography because I would have been so annoyed of the camera that I just want to do something else. Number four on my list, I mean, when I say my list, is I literally did the research for this article, actually for this vlog. I did my own research. So if you don't agree with me, please don't start hating me online and instantly just bragging on the comments. Just don't watch the video and go and do your own research if you don't trust me. Or write something in the comments that say why am I wrong or etc. Okay, so number four on my list after street photography, documentary photography, photojournalism, stock photography is landscape, wildlife and travel photography. I mean, this is the most popular photography. But that doesn't mean that it's the most paid, because there are a bunch of travel photographers, landscape photographers, now wildlife photographers, not so many, because it's very, very expensive style of photography. But I'm not gonna talk about the most expensive photography styles, because I'm gonna keep that topic for the next episode, which will be probably the next week, the same time. Yeah, that's how it's gonna be. So wildlife photography, I mean, you can always sell an amazing shot of two polar bears searching for food or two elephant bulls fighting for something. Yeah, you can always sell it in a gallery or in a magazine. But then landscape, especially if you're of those type of photographers that are constantly going to honeypot locations. If you don't know what honeypot location is, a term used by photographers that represents a very popular photography spot somewhere in the world. So let's say you're going to photograph Patagonia, the Fitzroy. I have a bunch of photographs from Fitzroy. Every other landscape photographer has a bunch of photographers from Fitzroy. I guess the magazines have terabytes of data that is with Fitzroy. So the chances that you're gonna be selling that image are pretty low. Unless you have captured, I don't know, something, some epic clouds mixing pink, green colors or whatever. So yeah, and also with the travel photography, yeah, it is popular, but every Instagrammer now is doing the same things. You can sell travel photography to new bloggers and stuff like that, but I think that it's pretty difficult now. Especially very difficult to get an exposure as a landscape or travel photographer, because the space is so crowded and there are so many amazing photographers out there that are still searching for jobs. But never give up. You will get that amazing light, and that amazing light will make your photos sell like candy. Number three on the list is family portraits or baby photography. So this is extremely popular now. I bet that every single one of you have seen those baby pictures where the baby is in a cradle, or it's something with a cute dog sleeping together with a nice head in a wooden basket or something like that. Okay, this is very popular, especially for the birthdays and for Christmas season. But the problem is now that number two on my list has started selling packages, including the services they sell, for this type of photography. So if you are just specializing in baby or family portraits, it will be difficult to get the gig because someone else is stealing it from you. But if you have the qualities, if you have your unique style in this one, you're definitely gonna sell. And this type of photography really spreads like wildfire. So my advice, if you are starting in this kind of a photography business, is that you go to your neighbors, to your friends, and ask if you can photograph their kids for free. I mean, they will be very happy because they will have some cool, amazing pictures of their children. I've read that there are photographers that are earning up to 10K for a photo shoot of a baby, especially in the Christmas season. So if you're thinking to starting your own photography business and you don't know which one to choose, I think that this one is a good idea because you can make a decent amount of money, the investment is not big, and plus you can always find clients. Number two is event photography / wedding / birthdays. But let's stick to the wedding. I mean, the weddings are booming. It's the most profitable. Okay, not the most. Yeah. Is the second most profitable photography style in the world. I mean, besides taking photos, you can start doing videos, you can start renting lights, you can start renting sound systems, you can start selling pictures directly to the guests. I know people that started just by taking photos, now they are doing videos, as I said. They are selling pictures to the guests directly on the wedding. They work with a printing studio, so the moment they are finished with the pictures, they are sending them to the studio is printing them in no time, delivering directly to the wedding, and after 3 hours of the photo shoot, girls are going table to table and selling the pictures to the guests for a fee. And that's how they earn lots of money. And also, now I forgot, they started doing the design for the wedding invitations. I mean, the wedding industry is so big that you can implement everything and sell it as a package and people will love it and buy it. The new thing, what they are doing, I said it in the previous photography style, is that they are having packages like future happiness. So while you are booking your wedding photo shoot and video shoot and everything, and they're saying for a discounted price of X dollars, you can book family photoshoot or baby photoshoot. So when the baby is born, you already have your baby photoshoot booked. You don't need to pay money, or you need to pay some small amount because you paid a deposit when you booked your wedding shoot, and then you have a new gig. Starting a wedding photography business can be a little bit more expensive and more difficult because it's super crowded and requires a very good portfolio. So before you start charging, I think that you should go out there in the field and do some weddings for free. Just do your friends' weddings or neighbors' weddings, or work for some pro just to learn the business. If you want to succeed in this kind of photography business, you need to have an amazing online portfolio. Online portfolio sells everything, but the biggest marketing in this business is word to mouth. So when you're going to take pictures for free of your neighbor's wedding or your friend's wedding, they are at least 5 potential clients on that wedding. Doesn't matter if it's engagement or wedding party. If they like the photos that you will take, they will hire you. So trust me, word to mouth is the best promoter of your business. Doesn't matter if you started working for free, if you have the qualities, clients will find you. Those weddings are your best marketing. Number one. It's marketing, social media, and corporate photography. These days, every small, medium, or large business knows that marketing is the key to their success. And marketing without photography is nothing. Having the best spot on Times Square in New York is not necessarily the best idea for your marketing, because social media has taken over the world and also has opened millions of jobs for photographers, designers, and videographers. You go on Instagram or Facebook and you're bombarded with ads by anyone that has at least $1 on their account. So deciding to go all in into this kind of photography business might be the best idea. But be aware, the competition is fierce. I mean, of course, where there is money, there is competition. The problem for freelance photographers that are working in this photography business is that major companies are employing dozens, hundreds, thousands of photographers to do this kind of jobs. So they're pushing the price of photography services down just to include them in the package of a service that they are selling. But you shouldn't be disappointed. If you have the qualities, if you have that amazing artistic touch, clients will find you and they will hire you. Because big clients want to have the photographer's name on their ad. They want it to be a perfect brand. They don't want those impersonal stock-like photographs made by their marketing company. They want the photographer's stamp. The same with designers. Recently I discovered a Hungarian photographer that is photographing miniature mock-ups of daily life. And guess who is his new client? Red freaking Bull! To grow your own marketing photography business, besides the things that I mentioned before in this video, I would recommend, if you are just beginning, go door to door to every small, medium business and offer them your services. Because each and one of them want to have an amazing pictures of their product or their services to put online. So guys, if you like this video and if you want me to continue doing this kind of videos every week, click like, click subscribe, and see you in the next video. Peace!